Madam, in the context of safety, I am supporting this bill. Madam, I am coming from the place that which more than 9 dams, including Idukki Arch Dam and Mullaperiyar also. While introducing this bill, our Honorable Minister has stated that the serious discussion about the dam safety has started at the time of Mullaperiyar dam's controversy arose. Sir, I am not going to the merits and demerits of the Mullaperiyar case and the judge and its judgments also. But I have to express the serious feelings of our own people regarding with the threat and fear of fear about the Mullaperiyar dam. Sir, every man-made structure have their own lifespan and life period. Let it be the Parliament building or the India Gate. Similarly, in the case of dams, there are serious and important study reports came out regarding with the Mullaperiyar dam. The dam is situating in an earthquake zone. The IIT report shown, and also the Central Water Commission report in 1979 pointed out the dangerous condition of that dam and recommended it should have been decommissioned by decades before. And also our Honorable Supreme Court directed to reduce the water level in the at the time of recent floods by the apprehension of the capacity and safety of this dam. We are living under the scare, because if anything happened to this dam, of course we can say Kerala will be divided into two parts. It is not only affecting my own district, but also the surrounding districts. Lakhs and lakhs of people will be the victims. Kerala will be divided into two. So I am supporting this bill up to any extent for the safety of dams. So we are in the position, all the 8 dams should be decommissioned by the study reports. I am coming to this bill. There are so many concerns and expressions from different parts of the country regarding with the legislative competency of the Parliament to enact this bill and its impacts on rights and authority of states on their dams management. The concerns already expressed by honorable members here. Moreover, that that means the superpower getting by this bill to central government may be misused. The political pressure may come from central government to each and every state relates to this these dam safety issues. In the clause 5(1)(c), central government can nominate the state government government's representatives also to different committees. It is a clear cut encroachment of principle of federalism. And also in clause 49, we all know there are 3 schedules. That means schedule 1, schedule 2 and schedule 3. That consists of the powers and functions of each committees. That powers and functions may be amended by a notification by the central government. This powers, that means the vesting the power to amend the amendment act with the executive government is very strange and against the settled principles of law. And also at the same time, the preamble of this bill states that it is for preventing the dam failure disasters. It is not for the system management after the dam failure. It is for preventing the failure of this disasters. If this is the real intention of the government, there must be a comprehensive study and assessment of those dams which are vulnerable to such disaster. I'm concluding, sir. Only 2 minutes. Clause 6 of this bill says that the function of National Committee on Dam Safety, that functions under the Schedule 1. I am suggesting to the first schedule must include an entry regarding study of present condition, structural details and expected lifespan of those dams which have already crossed 100 years of age. Dams that have crossed 100 years must be categorized separately and there must be separate provision for such dams. It has to be decommissioned by the recommendation in real time. National Dam Safety Committee must be conferred with the power to determine the maximum water level in each dam according to its capacity. The capacity of the dam must be assessed on the basis of its age and other relevant factors. All stakeholders should be heard in the process of determination of this water level. I come to the conclusion and do appreciate the central legislation, but in the same time I would say more deliberation to the stakeholders and states before this enactment. I'm supporting this bill under the in the context of dam safety. Thank you very much.
House may be, if everyone agrees, House may be extended till both bills are passed, item number 4 and 5.